The football field is one of destiny's unfolding. A typically sunny Sunday morning in Miami to many, but for two franchises it would be a watershed moment. To the general public, all they would see are two moribund teams seeking their first win of the season. But to the wise, they see a far more important battle. For Tua Tagovailoa, one of the top quarterback prospects in next year's NFL draft. Selecting him has the chance to change the fortunes and futures of many that are on his side. The fight for the first overall pick is one of struggles and sacrifice. Perhaps it's dignity. Perhaps it's current assets. Maybe both. But for those chosen few, this is no ordinary tank bowl. This is a super tank bowl. The Washington Redskins, a franchise whose only relevance is in publicly flogging their owner for the good of the world. With an 0-5 start despite an easy schedule, it has been an incredibly disappointing season for those that fancy themselves as good. In a desperation attempt at saving their season, they fired their token puppet and Jay Gruden for an older token puppet. Everything they touch dies. Free agent signings, first-round quarterbacks, respectability, everything. Hail to the Redskins. Today's opponent, the Miami Dolphins. On the contrary to Washington, they have fully embraced the tank. They are a liquidation sale in disguise as a football team. Their incredible awfulness is one we haven't seen since the expansion Buccaneers. No matter how much Brian Flores wants to proclaim that the team isn't tanking, he only brings reference to Baghdad Bob. Any schmuck with a microphone can see that they are an affront to football, but this is their big test to earn a prized Tua. A game for the ages in a perfect location. The unassuming mediocrity of Hard Rock Stadium. The privileged fans in attendance gripping with anticipation. Quarter number one would be full of action for the punters. Free and outs were commonplace. The trenches had stalled. No progress was being made. Who would blink first against the tank? It would be the Redskins. Old ass Adrian Peterson speeding around the tryhard Miami defenders like a South Beach tourist trap. A throwback to a time once respected as an elite running back. Same goes for Case Keenum. A beautiful spiral delivered to the emerging Terry McLaurin. The cornerback so impressed by his route he trips over in awe. Their offense may have been witnessing such a feat as well. Despite the relentless swarm of the Redskins' defense, they advanced the ball with magic. It is here a reality is proven. Josh Rosen committed terrible crimes in a past life. He is punished by having no offensive line whatsoever. The defense responds in kind with Grand Theft Football. After more stalling, the Dolphins proved their confidence in Rosen by running a draw play on a 3rd-and-11. It would lead to a rare sight in Miami. The Dolphins scoring points. With the Redskins leading 7-3 at halftime, it wasn't just a tank-off. It was an epic fight to the bottom. Another beautiful spiral to Terry McLaurin would emphasize this. Washington was winning the game, but Miami, they were thinking ahead. A crucial victory in the draft seeding was in their grasp. Josh Rosen and the offense were eternally cursed. The Redskins were charging as if they saw General Custer and his army of Dolphins in an open plain. Instead of attacking, though, they drop the ball and settle for a field goal. The Hogs even then keep up the pace and have a chance to put up 20 whole points. They miss this opportunity wide. Even then, their hollow win is safe. Washington leads by 14 going into the fourth quarter. There should be no chance for Miami to even sniff a comeback, but Brian Flores is delusional. He wants his first career win. He does not care for tanks. He preferred medieval warfare. Ancient warriors would be summoned in the form of Fitzception. Josh Rosen's failure to move an inch will no longer be tolerated. Starting the remainder of the season was void after three quarters. To the uninitiated, Ryan Fitzpatrick is only good for one thing. Ending any ambitions of tanking. His first drive would lead to a Dolphin touchdown. This would be the team's first points in the second half all season. You may laugh and cry at the same time. Now only down by 7, the quest for the tank is getting serious for both teams. The offensive drive stalling out at a rate only seen by the deadest of football eras. With 2 minutes left in the game, all Miami had to do was fail enough to turn over on downs. Then, and only then, would the true prize be theirs. Foolishly, they were intent on destroying their own tank. It's the worst feeling as a fan, watching your team, bit by bit, push forwards for a touchdown when it will do nothing for their season. All you can hope for is to pray for a massive faux pas to force a loss. It will have to be in these final 10 seconds.
Fitzpatrick throws! Touchdown! Devontae Parker!
The unfathomable horror. The Dolphins scored a touchdown. The tank would be ruined. Even worse, Miami wanted to go for two and end the game. All their fans could do was pray.
Matchups at the bottom of the screen. Preston Williams, Josh Norman.
Breaks his drink, he drops it!
Who the hell calls a screen pass on a two-point conversion? Even if he caught it, it was going to be sniffed out by the defense. Excuse me.
Perhaps it was Kenyon Drake doing his part for Tua before he's inevitably traded for a fifth-round pick. But thanks to his efforts, Miami has passed their first true test. They have won the Tank Bowl. The prize of Tua is closer despite all efforts of self-sabotage. Maybe that play call was to ensure the true triumph, but all we know is that all Tank Bowls should be like this. It was ugly. It was disorganized. It was the greatest game.
Quick to Drake, he dropped it! They wanted the quick throw, and Drake was gonna run it in.